today we'll be talking about the ejaculatory duct. The ejaculatory duct is the third region of the male ductile system after the epididymis and the vas deferens. We've done a lecture on the epididymis and the vas deferens. You can go and check that up to fit into this lecture. The ejaculatory duct is formed by the union of the vas deferens and the duct of the seminal vesicle. This is the vas deferens, and this duct unites with the duct of the seminal vesicle to form the ejaculatory duct, and this is the ejaculatory duct. The ejaculatory duct is a very short duct that is about 2 centimeters in length, and it pierces through the prostate gland. This is the prostate gland to be emptied into the prostatic part of the urethra. This is the urinary bladder. And at the exit of the urinary bladder, we have the urethra. This is the urethra and the initial segment of the urethra that runs across the prostate gland is the prostatic urethra. And it is this specific region that the ejaculatory duct empties into. So sperm that is coming from the vas deferens, we run through this duct. When they get to this region, the secret from the seminal vesicle will also be emptied into it. And together, they will unite to form the ejaculatory duct before they finally go down the tract through the prostatic urethra, down to the membranous urethra, then to the penile or spongy urethra. Let's look at the path through which the ejaculatory duct runs. It is a straight duct. It is not convoluted. It is a straight duct that pierces through the prostate gland to be emptied into the prostatic urethra. And this is how they run, a straight course and not convoluted as seen in other regions. Immediately after the urinary bladder, we have the pre-prostatic urethra. And from this region down to this region, we have the prostatic urethra. So along halfway of the length of the prostatic urethra is where the ejaculatory duct empties into. So it is a short course that they run that can justify their length, which is about 2 cm. The functions. The first function is that they help to provide a route through which the seminal vesicle empty its secret into. This is the seminal vesicle and this is the duct of the seminal vesicle. And into the ejaculatory duct is where they empty their secret into. It also serves as a route through which the sperm coming from the vas deferens empties into. Also within this region, the sperm coming from the vas deferens and the secrets from the seminal vesicle will be mixed within the ejaculatory duct. So it also creates a space for the mixing of the content from vas deferens and that of the seminal vesicles. Apart from allowing transportation and also creating a space to mix the content coming from the vas deferens and the seminal vesicle, they also help to support the process of ejaculation. We said that during ejaculation, the wall of the ductile system are innervated by sympathetic innervation, and this tends to constrict the wall. And as they constrict the wall, they are helping to push down the content, down the tract. So the ejaculatory duct also help in a way to support the process of ejaculation. So thanks for watching.